I'll tell you a little bit about my company before we get started. Yeah. So I'm president of Code Entertainment. Code Entertainment is a production, independent production company, and we produce and finance independent films. We've done, as I said, You Kill Me, did Drowning Mona with Danny DeVito and Bette Midler, Jamie Lee Curtis. We did this film Noel with Robin Williams, Susan Sarandon, and Paul Walker and Penelope Cruz. We've recently done a couple of horror movies. One was called Behind the Mask, which was pretty well received. We're in post-production on a movie now called The Boy in the Box with John Hamm and Josh Lucas. And we also have a management company where we manage writers and directors. And those are mostly studio writers and directors. We manage George Wing, who wrote 51st Dates. We manage Jose Rivera, that wrote The Motorcycle Diaries. We manage Ken Kwapis, who... he's doing the new movie He's Just Not Into You, and also this is sort of the traveling pants and the pilot for The Office. So we have a combination of our company is a production company and a management company, and that's what we do.
By the way, who were we talking to yesterday who worked on You Kill Me?
Carol Baum.
Yeah, she was one of the producers on You Kill Me, right?
So was that, did she start with it and then bring it to you guys?
Yes. And she did. And then we ended up finishing the casting and financing and producing.
Okay, so in that case, you're a financing source for independent movies?
Well, we're not solely a financing source. We we're producers. So we're producers that have financing, and we will finance movies that we produce. Yeah. We don't write checks for other people's movies.
Well, no, that's good to know.
Yeah, so making your movie for the buyers rather than making the movie for the audience. And the studios are only thinking about making the movie for their audiences. So the buyers for our films are actually the studios, whereas the buyers for the studio films are actually the audience out there. So it's a little bit of difference. So the studio movies, they get to make the decision as to how much money they're going to put into it, and then they know that it's eventually going to get out there and be seen by all these people. On the independent side, you make the movie, and then you have the speculation of, oh, are people going to actually buy it so it can get seen? So from that point of view, it is more speculative. But of course, the studio movies, you know, they could spend $100 million, and then they can end up losing 50. On an independent movie, you can spend 12 and end up losing 6. So it's a little...
So are all the movies that you've gotten through production, have they all gotten distribution?
Well, they've all been distributed, yeah, but some of them have been... you know, on DVD release, but you know, you always hope that they go theatrical, and fortunately most of them have.
And do you try to get distribution before you start production?
You know, it all depends. If it used to be, a few years ago, it was a lot easier. If you had a really important actor, you were definitely going to get distribution. So for example, we did a movie, Palmetto, with Woody Harrelson and Elizabeth Shue. And that movie, Woody Harrelson had just gotten off his, had just been nominated for People vs. Larry Flint, who was very hot, and Elizabeth Shue had just been nominated for Leaving Las Vegas. So as soon as we cast those two together, we sold that movie to Castle Rock in 5 days, and we hadn't even started pre-production. Now, if you get important actors, unless you have a really strong director, they still want to see some of the footage. So it has changed a little bit.
So on the indie side, is the main value of theatrical release that by the time it gets to DVD, everybody will know it, or is there a...
Well, the main value of theatrical release is that you get a much wider audience, because the theatrical release ends up being the advertising for the DVD and television release. So sometimes what happens is we find that after the movies are on HBO or something like that, then all of a sudden people, the movie has a higher profile even though it never went out theatrically. So some of our movies that are on television all the time on either Comedy Central or HBO or whatever have a high profile now, but it takes a longer to get there when you don't have the theatrical release.
And are you guys keep the copyright?
Well, that's an interesting question. There's all different ways to sell these movies, and sometimes if you sell it to a studio, they want to keep the copyright, or sometimes you only sell them a license for 20 years. And so they're all different.
So, and if you get copyright, then of course you're in business on that same movie every time it shows up on television.
Well, and every time the license, because the way you sell them is you sell them for a period. So you're usually at a 10-year, 15-year, or 20-year licenses. And then they give you an amount up front for that. And then when that license expires in 15 years, then you can resell it again.
So ultimately, you guys have a library, right?
We have a library. Yeah. But they're all different pieces of different movies, because some have been sold in perpetuity and some haven't. And you don't know what the deal is.
Cool. So what does it take? Now, what percentage are you doing on the financing versus actually producing? I'm just wondering.
Well, all the movies that we finance, we produce. We don't do just any, just financing, and then we don't produce them.
Okay. So then that means all the movies you do, you produce every one of them?
Yes.
Right? Okay. All right, good. And so do you guys start from the very beginning, as in from a script or from a concept, or do you do any development, any of that kind of thing?
Well, I think it's, you know, interesting for a writer's group to know how, you know, we get these scripts. And there's all different ways that we get screenplays. So the obvious way is to get them from an agent, and the agent sends you the script, and then that would presume that the writer has an agent. And there are a lot of very talented writers out there that don't have agents. So, for example, I got a call from my mother one day. She said, you know, your cousin Roeder's neighbor in the Long Island wants to be a screenwriter, and he's coming out to Los Angeles. So I met with him. And he gave me this script, and I read it, and it was really good. Wow, you know, this script's pretty good. So over the course of a year, we ended up making that movie, and it became Drowning Mona, which was Danny DeVito, Bette Midler, Jamie Lee Curtis, and Ned Campbell. And that writer was Peter Steinfeld, who went on to write Analyze That and Be Cool and all these big movies. And now he's doing better than I am.